Dear viewers, today we are going to see how IoT, that is Internet of Thing based used system, how we are going to transmit the data from MATLAB Simulink to ThingSpeak. MATLAB Simulink to ThingSpeak, how we are going to be transferring the data from that MATLAB Simulink, ThingSpeak. This is the ThingSpeak, that is the ThingSpeak which is available in this is the ThingSpeak web page for the respective channels, right? So the main specialty of that video is there is no external hardware. The Simulink desktop real-time IoT block, which is available in the Simulink library, I have drag and drop this block in the MATLAB Simulink file, and I am configuring this block. How I can configuring before I am configuring this block. I am also going to do the install and uninstall for the install real time kernel. How I can install by using the sldrtkernel -install command. So whenever I am going to put this command in the command window, so immediately you are going to install the Simulink desktop real time kernel. Yes, I am also going to give the Y signal, Y symbol, Y letter. Again, the real time kernel which is installed in our desktop or laptop in the MATLAB. Okay, now that is the next step. I am going to double click this. So before entering to that, I am also giving that channel, that is the channel ID and configuration, what is the API. So this API value which is that is available here, that is it is available in the API keys, that is API keys. So this API keys, write command or write API keys, which is available. So this is the write API key. So I am also copy and already I have pasted this API keys in the configuration. So after that channel ID, that is I am also giving this for test. So testing the system. So after the test will be okay, again the symbol which is available, everything, the test will be okay. So after okaying the test, you may, yes, now the device availability has been verified. This is very, very important. You have get this the output. Now I am also run this file in the infinite. The time is infinite slot. Now the value is 1250. Okay, 1250. We are going to see the private view. In the private view, that is already, that is 3500 which is available. Now I am going to start run. This is okay. Okay, which is I am also going to set. Again, this is okay. This block is okay. So whenever this block is okay, which is available, again I am also going to give that command for this block is okay. So again further I am going to run. Please see that the videos. That is the now I am going to run with the infinitive. So each and every time we need the 15 second for the free user data updating time. Suppose if you are going to get the time for the user, commercial user, the instantaneously data is updated, but it will need the some certain 15 second on here. The maximum last update is 8:40. So now it is changed. It is video recorded. Okay. Now I am going to change that the 750. I am entering the value of 750 in MATLAB Simulink. So that is we are waiting for some second, right? Oh, say right. So what is that the values? So that is already existing 3500. Again, it may be reduced to that 1250. Again, 750 I am also entering. So this is the 750. Now it can be entered. Now again, I am going to change this value for 3760. Okay, 760. That is very okay. So because above this value, we are going to identify. Again, we are waiting the 15 seconds time lag. Suppose if you are getting the commercial user ID, you are able to easily transmit the data. For that, the maximum. Now the data is increased. For 37, please see the cursor value. That is, what is the value? 3760. Please see the value, that is 3760. Okay, now this video is, you are going to transferring the your MATLAB Simulink data into the what is that, the ThingSpeak cloud database without external hardware requirement. It is very important thing. In next video I will give that the that is the hardware based data reading and then upload that the data in the cloud without any external hardware. Okay. Right.